Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Wherever you're watching this from, welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Happy hump day, happy Wednesday, bright, beautiful, shiny Wednesday. And the skies are blue and gray. Champions League is back. The upper echelon, the creme de la creme. Champions League qualification games are going on today. And we're going to get down to all the games that are about to go down. Lionel Messi has also become the subject of conversation. And I'm going to give you the tidbits, or should I say the summary of what is going on with Lionel Messi as he joined the MLS, winning the Super Cup, winning the cup with Inter Miami. It's going to be a long season. The MLS has not been quantified as one of the greatest leagues in the world based upon the performance and the skill level in the league. But regardless of how the defensive capabilities in the MLS is low, you cannot understate what Lionel Messi has been able to do just by coming in. And in as much as it's just Lionel Messi who's getting all the glory, we shouldn't fail to acknowledge that Sergio Busquets and Jordi Alba also came with him. And these are like the backbone of that Barcelona tiki-taka run. So it's not just Messi. I mean, yes, we all like to sing the praise of the magical genius, and what he does on the field can never be understated. But we should not forget that also Sergio Busquets and Jordi Alba has helped the defensive mechanism of this Inter Miami team. And the difference between playing a tournament and playing a league is that in a league, when it's a long season, there could be injuries, there could be unforeseen factors. So let's not assume that it's going to be all easy and all rosy for Lionel Messi in the MLS. I watched the game against Nashville, and I tip my hats out to Nashville how they played as well. The MLS is on the up. The level Lionel Messi coming in has really helped elevate the expectations. Everybody wants to play to a certain level. And I take my hats out to Nashville also. It was a very wonderful final. It was 1-1. They went to penalties. Very entertaining. Kudos to Inter Miami for winning that as well. Like I said, Champions League games are coming back. So this is the lower seed leagues around the world who want to play with the big boys. So before the big boys arrive, the middle boys have to play among themselves to see who is the biggest among the little boys to match up to the big boys. So games are going on in the Champions League yesterday. Very entertaining game. Glasgow Rangers played 2-2 with PSV Eindhoven, Scotland and Netherlands. The game was amazing. 2-2 draw. And Antwerp beat AEK Athens 1-0. Rako Shizusawa beat Copenhagen. Copenhagen beat them 1-0. Today, Molde is playing Turkish Giants. Galatasaray, Braga is playing Panathinaikos. Maccabi Haifa is playing Young Boys. And mind you that the Premier League is returning this weekend as well. But before we get to the Premier League, there's an issue that is circulating the sporting world around the president of the Spanish Football Federation, after the Spanish woman won the World Cup, kissed one of the players, Jenny, on the lips in a show of, I don't know whether it's happiness or joy or whatever the situation is. There's no room for abuse. Whether you thought it was a joke or it wasn't a joke, there's no room for abuse, nepotism, political, anything in the game of football and soccer. And people are calling for the president to resign. And I'm just speaking from information I've gathered is that the lady who was kissed said she wasn't comfortable with it. Initially, I thought, okay, maybe they are lovers in behind closed doors, or they are friends, or that's a game they play. The lady involved, the Spanish captain, apparently came out to say she was uncomfortable when he did that. I mean, why do you kiss a woman on the lips if you want to show your sign of appreciation for their efforts? You can at least give them even hugs. Has to be warranted. You don't just go about kissing people. So yes, still talking about the things women go through in this beautiful game of football and soccer, and how a blind eye is turned to it. This is just something they go through all the time. Females in sports. unwarranted advances and abuse. And apparently there's been an issue going on since 2 years back, where there certain players in the Spanish team had to resign and say, we're not going to play for this team anymore, based upon the practices and the unprofessionalism that is surrounding the team. So I'll keep you informed as it goes, but there's a video on online that you can look for it. I think he should resign as well, even though, I mean, this is not a place to show such level of machismo. I don't even know how to understand. Anyways, so that also going on in the world. We send light, and we send love to all victims of abuse, or people, women in sports going through all this toxic masculinity. You can call it that. That is toxic masculinity. Thank you for tuning in to Awesome Sports. Premier League is coming down this week, this Friday, and Chelsea is playing against Luton Town. And as a Chelsea fan, I don't even know what to expect, because Chukwuemeka is injured. Christopher Nkunku is not there. Reece James knows how to pick his time to get in. I mean, I don't blame him for getting injured. It's a natural occurrence. But why does it every time that we need him the most? Christopher Nkunku, who showed promise and that connection with Nicholas Jackson. Nicholas Jackson is an amazing player, and I have no doubt that he will score goals and he will do great in the Premier League. But the Premier League is a game of right now, not a game of tomorrow. And Chelsea need to provide results right now. And the transfer window is not over yet. They need to find a striker right now. Thank you for tuning in to Awesome Sports. Chelsea is playing Luton Town, and Mauricio Pochettino finds himself in a quadrangle of conundrums. He's dealing with injuries. He's dealing with players who don't have what it takes to play for Chelsea. And he still has to let some people go so more can come in. Moise Caicedo, I mean, it was quite unfortunate that his first game, the team's stability when he came into the game was so off that he made a mistake and give away a penalty. But I look forward to see what Moise Caicedo will do. But Luton Town should not be a problem for Chelsea. Okay, Chelsea playing Luton Town on Friday. Bournemouth playing Tottenham on Saturday. Brentford, Crystal Palace on Saturday as well. Arsenal, Fulham Saturday. Manchester United, will they be able to beat Nottingham Forest after coming off a defeat from Tottenham Hotspur? Man U play Nottingham Forest. Everton is playing Wolves. Brighton, they're flying high, shining. Mitoma getting a splendid goal last weekend. Brighton is playing West Ham. Sheffield United is playing Man City on Sunday. Sorry for Sheffield United. It will be a one-upping. Burnley is playing Aston Villa, and Newcastle, that will be the blockbuster game on the weekend, is playing Liverpool. Thank you for watching Awesome Sports. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0 available on all platforms. New ASCM music coming. More tune on the way. Click the link in the bio. Happy Hump Day. This is Awesome Sports. We'll be done till.